Hi, I'm Terry Brock with TerryBrock.com. Recently, I had an opportunity to go visit a wonderful place on Earth that many people pilgrimage to and they enjoy it. Being from Orlando, I'm familiar with Disney World, of course, and we see what people do when they go to Disneyland or Disney World or other places like that. Well, I saw something comparable going to Dublin, Ireland to Guinness. And I want to talk with you about that today. Five sales lessons from the genius of Guinness. And I want to share with you some important business lessons that I learned while being there that you can learn as well. And besides, you'll get a chance to see some of the fun of it here. And I was on site at the St. James's Gate Brewery in Dublin, Ireland. And by the way, that's how they spell it. Notice I put it in there, the J-A-M-E-S apostrophe S is the way they put it in there. So for you grammarians who are trying to correct me, hey, go back to Guinness. Look at that. But really, I was right there and got a chance to see it. And I was really impressed with what they do and how they do it and thought, here's some lessons that you and I can learn from this as well. Number one, they cultivate their legacy. See, they were started in 1759, long time ago, by Arthur Guinness himself. We have to almost salute Sir Arthur. I'll call him Sir Arthur. I don't know if he was or not, but he is to me. So I think he did a great job, but he gave us that wonderful nectar of the gods called Guinness. And it's a legacy that they cherish and they talk about referring to it. Think about that in your company, how you can go back, even if it's just a couple years ago, you can say, when we founded this company, it was based on the principles that are important to you that resonate with your customers. That's key. Not just any principles, but those that resonate. Guinness talks about their clarity of water and how they use their care in doing it, and they really do a good job with it. Secondly, premium priced, and they're proud of it. Guinness positions itself as not just at the regular price of other brews, but a little bit different. And as a matter of fact, they make a big point saying it's not another beer, it's Guinness, putting it into a separate category. And so think about how you can do that, how you can look at premium pricing and get away from the commodity, you know, the spiral downward, like, well, we can do it for less. Instead, look at premium pricing. That's particularly true for thought leaders. For if you're an author, if you're a speaker, if you're a coach, consulting your rendering services, an accountant, a lawyer, yeah, you can try to always compete on the basis of lower price, but find what the customers, what bill payers, what your clients are going to value, and then to capitalize on that. That's a key. Guinness also has a loyal following. That's the third point that I see. They've got people that are really incredible. Look at this, for instance. I got this picture inside. These people here get their picture in front of the Guinness Brewery, like I did, and they wanted to get that picture. Lots and lots of people coming by. I mean, hundreds of people, I could guess, every day, maybe thousands, that are coming to that St. James's Brewery there in Dublin, Ireland. So you want that to let people participate in something more than just the product itself. They get involved with it. And speaking of that, number four, Guinness is more than just a product. They've got all kinds of merchandise around it, as you suspect. Yes, of course, a little pint like this that you can buy there, and they've got a nice store, but lots and lots of other things that are there. And so you can see from shirts and caps and golf equipment and all kinds of things that are available because people like it, much like a Harley Davidson or Apple. People will use that and put the logos, you know, that they'll wear. And like with Harley, sometimes people put it as a tattoo on their body. So I imagine there might be some that do that with Guinness. I don't, but there's a lot of opportunities you can have. Think about how you can go beyond your product. Think about how you can create something that extends. Make it, of course, customized to what you're doing with your product. And like, for instance, they had this also, a dining hall, where you could go in and you can get a wonderful meal. And by the way, I have to say the food was great. Yes, you could get a pint of Guinness, but the food that they had was traditional Irish food as well as other kinds, and was just really, really good. And reasonably priced, too. I was expecting it to be a lot more, but it was very reasonably priced. And number five, Guinness is infinitely renewable. As you can see, this fine young man there with a pint of Guinness in his hand, enjoying that, and he's had that one. He did consume that one, I hear. Read it in a book somewhere that he did, and he'll probably get a few more in the future. So it's something you want to think about, is how it can be continually and infinitely renewable. That is something you want to go for. Think about how you can use these principles yourself in your business and do it as Guinness does. They're from the brewery. See, I sacrifice a lot for you, for these videos, being there in person in Dublin, Ireland, enjoying a little pint of Guinness. It was good. And enjoy that yourself. If you ever get a chance to get over there, by all means do it. Five lessons from the genius of Guinness. I'm Terry Brock with TerryBrock.com. Thank you for joining me, and I will look forward to your comments. Tweet this out. to your favorite folks there on Twitter. Send it out to on Facebook and a reference. We really appreciate that. And if you have some comments, we'd love to hear from you over at terrybrock.com. That's T-E-R-R-Y, and Brock is spelled the right way, B-R-O-C-K. So terrybrock.com. Thanks for joining me. I look forward to hearing from you.